I'm Troy Kirby with my Edmonds News, with a quick look at the 2021 Washington State Legislative Session. The House Consumer Protection and Business Committee held a public hearing on House Bill 1424, which would prohibit a retail pet store from selling cats and would prohibit a retail pet store from selling dogs unless certain conditions are met.
The reason I took on this issue and wanted to defend retail pet stores is, as a lot of people on this committee know, in 2016, our daughter was the victim of a sexual assault. She went through a lot of trauma, post-traumatic stress disorder, and a counselor recommended to us that we get her an emotional support animal. We thought this is easy. We love rescue animals. She volunteers at a shelter in Issaquah. We'll just go down to the shelter and get the dog. They'd recommended that we get her a husky. We were not able to get that dog. We were told that we didn't have the proper backyard. We lived in Federal Way. We didn't have the proper fencing. That huskies are an active breed of dog. What you all need to understand is that year our daughter had not one, she had two suicide attempts. We were in desperate need to get an animal from any place. And we didn't want someone telling us we had to have a certain breed or certain type of dog. I posted my woes on Facebook and a hobby breeder contacted us from the Tri-Cities and we acquired not one, but two huskies. So when we tell you that, the underlying bill would not have been good for communities, especially for parents in our situations, people of color face a lot of coded questions when we go into to adopt pets. It's not to impugn the character of anybody on this committee, it's to give you a more diverse perspective in what we go through.
Based on our research, currently there are three Washington pet stores that are connected to inhumane puppy mills, some among the worst puppy mills in the country. One of these stores has attempted to expand throughout Washington over the past year. Puppy mills rely on pet stores to sell their puppies because no consumer would ever purchase that animal if they saw the conditions in which the puppies and the parent dogs were raised.
We're very transparent with our customers when they purchase the puppy. They go home with their breeder information. They go home with those OFA health certificates that I mentioned earlier. And they go off with a signed off vet check form from our local veterinarian. So this bill is written, not addressing the amendment. It limits the breeders our store can work with, and it's removing amazing professional breeders that work hard to produce healthy puppies. They really love what they do. So we have asked breeders, brokers, industry veterinarians, virologists, and other industry professionals to submit written testimony to you so that you guys can have a better insight into our industry, how we work, and what we do.
We believe that the best way to put an end to the puppy mill to pet store pipeline is to prohibit the retail sale of pets. However, we recognize and respect that the committee is not ready to take that step, and we have worked very hard within our own organization and with other animal welfare stakeholders to get to a place where we can support the approach of House Bill 1424, because it protects consumers, and it also ensures that this problem in Washington State does not get any worse. I want to make it clear that this bill is not a ban on the retail sale of pets in stores. This bill will not prevent or limit access to pets, nor will it force consumers to choose adoption. All of the breeders and stores that sell pets to the public today will be able to continue doing so. The bill will simply implement necessary consumer protection measures to ensure all pets offered for sale at existing retail outlets are sourced from breeders that meet Washington standards.
I'm coming to you with two hats, one as a city council for Olympia and two as a veterinarian. And I'm sorry, I'm at work, so I'm in my garb. The experience as a veterinarian has a mixture of being a specialist, but also an ER vet. And I have seen what happens when these puppies and the parents, the breeders, come to my clinic. And I have seen the various diseases that can happen when you overcrowd puppies, you take them long distances in cars, when they're not able to handle minor changes in temperatures, much less miss meals. And their calories go down, their sugar goes down, they can go into hypoglycemic shock, they can get all kinds of infectious diseases. So improperly run breeding facilities and stores can unfortunately risk the lives of not only the babies, but also the adults who may never see the comfort of a couch, make a human bond, much less take a walk, and sometimes are restricted into cages that are barely larger than themselves.
While I'm not speaking for the city, I want to make clear that our city passed an ordinance unanimously that banned stores that sell for-profit animals that come from cat and puppy mills, or of and in themselves are cat and puppy mills. We passed this ordinance for several reasons. These stores practice predatory loaning. Two, the animals such as dogs are bred and kept in such deplorable conditions that buyers often get sickly animals. And three, stores such as PetSmart or Petco aren't impacted because these stores' main retail products are items that owners need for their pets, not the sale of the animals themselves. These stores work closely with animal service agencies or rescue organizations, and they follow licensing requirements. Fourthly, we heard from many of our residents in Lacey encouraging us to pass our ordinance because these for-profit pet stores sadly do not care about the animals they sell, and they don't want this type of business in our community.
To be able to focus our attention specifically on the health and well-being of our animals, we choose to market our puppies through our broker, Jack's Puppies. This method of marketing requires full transparency into our program and our standards of care. It has allowed us to meet face-to-face numerous pet stores that source our puppies through Jack's, including the owners of Puppyland, Justin and Kayla. This is a successful working relationship where both Jack's and Puppyland have visited our facility and have been able to provide continual insight about our program. Even though our program goes above and beyond the rules and regulations that we have to follow, the proposed bill would prohibit the stores in Washington from receiving our puppies.
The House Finance Committee heard public testimony on House Bill 1496, which would install up to a 10% capital gains tax on long-term assets, which the IRS has stated is an income tax. The legislation has been criticized as a violation of the Washington State Constitution, which does not allow for an income tax.
This is why the IRS and every state in the country makes it clear that a capital gains tax is an income tax. And I provided the committee members copies of that letter from the IRS, as well as statements from all 50 states. This is also why the 9 states without income taxes don't tax capital gains. If enacted, this would be the first standalone capital gains tax in the country.
In Washington State, the place where I was born and raised, the upside-down tax code greatly exacerbates racial and economic inequities in bad times and in good. Washington State has a choice to make right now. It can muddle through the crisis without addressing the effects of structural barriers that leave Washingtonians worse off, or it can pursue an anti-racist, equitable recovery that takes aim at the concentration of wealth in our country and invests in families and communities that have been sidelined by racism and economic inequality.
And next we will hear from Shwarma Sawat. Go ahead.
Good morning, Chair Frame, Vice Chair, member of the House Finance Committee. I'm Shwarma Sawat, Seattle Socialist City Council member and a rank and file member of the Teachers Union, AFT Local 1789, in support of House Bill 1496. To say a bill to tax extreme wealth and profiteering is overdue is a gross understatement. Systematic long-term starving of public resources has led to criminal underfunding of education, housing, healthcare, jobs, and human services. But now, even during a pandemic, American billionaires' net worth has increased by a staggering $1 trillion. Politicians in Olympia have a historic responsibility to urgently pass statewide taxes on the wealthy. I urge you to also publicly commit to enact these taxes without undermining local taxing authority for progressive taxes. Last year, our Tax Amazon movement scored a historic victory during the Black Lives Matter protests when thousands of community members fought for and won Seattle's tax on biggest corporations to fund COVID relief, affordable housing, and Green New Deal projects. The City Council
Member, can you please keep your comments? Can you keep your comments focused on the bill at hand, please?
It is focused on the bill at hand. Last month, state lawmakers told Crosscut that they will need to, quote unquote, phase out Seattle's Amazon tax as part of enacting a statewide business
Council
tax
member,
measure.
That's not related to the current bill.
I'm sorry. I have a constitutional right to testify, and you should not be interrupting me.
In matters of decorum, we need you focused on the bill at hand.
No, you are completely subverting the Constitution. Public comment, impugning the intentions, even as you said, is 100% protected by the First Amendment. Would you please let me continue?
If it is focused on the bill at hand, Council
Member. It is focused on every bill that you will talk about on taxing wealthy and big business. So please let me continue. Last month, state lawmakers told Crosscut that they will need to, quote unquote, phase out Seattle's Amazon tax as
council part member. Of I've asked you three times to stay focused
that
on the
they
bullet
wanted
hand.
To avoid, quote unquote.
I'm sorry. I've asked everybody to stay focused on the bill at hand and to honor decorum. And that is not, I've asked you three times to stay focused on the bill at hand. This is not a reference to the bill that passed in the city of Seattle. Thank you, council member. Vice Chair Berg, our next panelist, please.
Thank you for watching the Daily Legislative Report by My Edmonds News, covering the 2021 legislative session.